temperature giving you a case of spring fever? Well, before you take to the outdoors and maybe plant your vegetables and your flowers, you need to make a plan. NewsHour's Michelle Hopkins breaking down tonight what to plant and when. I'm going to be listening to this, Michelle.
Okay, all right. Cherie's kind of anxious like a lot of people today, getting outside and getting their hands dirty doing yard work. Tonight, some tips on your garden and to keep it growing even now.
Yard and gardeners are chomping at the bit.
I seen the beautiful weather this morning and I'm like, I got to get my green thumb out and ready to start digging in the dirt.
I'm ready.
The beds have to be all cleaned out first.
Experts say Mr. Riley's got it right. Rake and scrape first and then break up your soil. You want to get it loose, let it breathe, and do it now. The guys at Barge Landscaping are planting flowering shrubs. Also, pretty good time for fruit trees. About the only flowers safe to plant now, the pansy.
It can take the cold. That is their shining glory.
And is it
they'll
low
take
maintenance?
Cold. Very low maintenance.
Yeah. Experts say in a couple of weeks you can go all out with planting vegetables.
Mid-March is a good time to plant potatoes, peas, lettuce right into the garden soil. It's ready to go. Everybody wants an early tomato, so they put them in pots and get them started indoors, then move them outside when it warms up.
And if you're really anxious, they actually make a heating pad that can help get your seeds going. It runs about $30.
So bottom line, the experts say take advantage of the beautiful days like we've been having to get a jump start on your yard and garden. It'll pay off for you later. Jack and Tree.